It's again, it's just really choice. Here's the idea, and that is, do people want to keep the view they've always had, or do they want a new view? And so you have to explore. And how do you do this? So the what we're talking about and what I've written as references gives the hint. That's all it can do. So, you know, that's up to the individual. Yeah, it would seem like it's a battle or a war. Well, it's really with ourselves. We really decide, do we want a new view, or do we want to just see things as we always have and do what we always have, you see? So it's like a builder, you know. And I was a builder. I was a general contractor for 40 years. And so do I want to just keep building the same houses? Do I want to just keep building and building, you know? And I decided, no, I don't. At some point, I decided that for a while, that was fine. You know, while I was doing things with the corporation, which Paul had created, et cetera, at that time for many years, for over 30 years. And for that time, it was fine. But it came to a point where, no, I want a new adventure, a new life, and a new view. So it's a decision, isn't it? But I've seen it through the years. I would say that, again, it's choice. People make a choice. And for most people, they will go back to their personal life. You still have your personal life. This is what people don't get, is that you still got your personal life, you know, but you decide how to enhance it. And so for the most part, what people will do, they'll just put all this aside. And just like in book two, the girlfriend I had at the time, Heather, at a certain point, she decided that it was, no, I want to go back. And this is all illusion. These guys are dead or whatever her idea was. And so, people decide their lives. They decide however it is, and that's how it's going to be. So the whole of life, yeah, that's a biggie. That's a challenge. That's always going into the unknown and becoming unknown, really. You really do. The only reason that, Rebazar and the boys and whatever are here, mainly for me, simply because, what Joni has done with Harry, especially with Harry, little by little pushing them out, you see. She knows that she still has to use Paul as the founder, okay? But realistically, that's not the focus. That becomes the difference. See, she's just using that, just like if you go to the White House, you see pictures of the presidents, you know, George Washington and all that, Abraham Lincoln, what have you, Roosevelt, all these things like carved in Mount Rushmore. You know, these people don't care about any of that. They sincerely don't, for the most part. Some of them do. Maybe they're a little historians or, you know, they got a little sentimental attitude. But for the most part, they don't care. That's just marketing. You gotta use something, you see. And so, but I do. I put these individuals forward where, the other paths that have been created, the Dhanami, the Vardenkar, the, you know, which I've mentioned many times, and they get upset with me when I say this. What's the idea? Oh, they got the rod of power. They're the master. They're the 972nd, whatever. It's fine. Have fun. You can do whatever you want. That's not the idea. I put everything before me. I feel grateful. It's all about gratitude with me that I even know this. And so the whole of life is bigger. It's not about me. But Ava and I market ourselves. the way we do as the new man is, etc., simply because we simply represent these individuals. And you might say keeping them alive here. So by the very fact we do that, they support us. And this is why the real guides don't support Harry and Varden Carr and Denami and Scientology and the Way of Truth and John Roger Hinkins. And I go on and on, Messiah, all these things, even though they may mention these things, because realistically they see the intent of these individuals, just like they see the intent of the politicians and the religious paths, etc. They see the intent, so they don't touch them. They don't back them. Life doesn't back it. You're just like floating in space like a satellite. It's your own idea you're clinging to. They don't back it, even though their names may be in the book somewhere. But they see that as marketing ploy. That's what Harry does, you know. He uses these things. And people do in the corporation and many places have experiences with them. This is very real. But it, and they can think that, oh, this has to do with, you know, the Eck and Carr or Varden Carr or whatever. It doesn't. It deals with the individual. It doesn't mean that the boys back that. No, they're backing what we're doing. Because it's real. Our intent, our sincerity, it's very real. And this is showing up. It has for years and years and years through the experiences of others. And it's, you know, you've shared some recent experiences, etc. There have been many, many more. And anyone can see it on the real side if they're sincere. It'll be shown. And some people do pay attention. So, again, it's a very interesting example of what we're going through here. And again, it's choice. I don't see any battle of anything, but I mean, those ideas come up and it's interesting you share those. But the only battle is that the individual with themselves, we all battle ourselves in our own way because it's a personal self, because we have cause and effect here and it's agitation. And realistically, you don't see the sun battling anything. You don't see the air or whatever, or the sea, even the ocean battling anything, simply because it's not the same as us with the different sides of ourselves, etc. So these ideas can come up, but realistically they're not. It's more fun to focus on the natural environment and do something creative that makes sense, especially now with the huge demise of this planet, to take on the challenge to step up. And this is where, when we all get together, we do something fun and see what happens. But the bigger picture is to learn to recognize the whole of life more so than just creation, but with creation involved also. So it all implies, yes.
Thank you for listening to this video. The NUUU Nations United Universal University is dedicated to supporting and providing a real purpose and real awareness with the all-natural environment supporting all of us. First comes this earth with food and rainforests, and to protect what is still here. If you want to know more, contact USA Dean Val and UK Dean Kevin on Facebook and YouTube, or through the website provided in the links, DwayneTheGreatWriter.net. For those who have the awareness to see what is actually taking place here with all the natural devastation, which is also purposely planned by world controllers, you now have a real opportunity to step up and do something with those who also care about your planet Earth. Duane Lee Hepner has created the NUUU, Nations United Universal University, which completely entails the all-natural environment everywhere, and a real education that has real value, and that far surpasses any commonly created indoctrinating educational system that does not focus on what sustains all of us naturally. Real survival makes sense with everything here that is self-sustaining.